The autofocus is the conversation and the topic about these cameras entirely, and they do so many things incredibly well, and yet people want to keep throwing the autofocus under the bus and talking about how it's so awful that it's really even not worth it. And I wanted to create this video to show you some samples of why I think it's not as bad at all as people claim. In fact, I have some tips in this video that will show you ways to get much better results than what people are showing. Well, first off, if this is your first time at this channel, I appreciate you being here. Thanks for checking out this video. I try to do videos like this as often as possible with gear reviews, and I try to just eliminate a lot of just all the science and the technical terms that bore people with a lot of the videos and try to just really show you footage, show you tests, and talk about what works for me and what doesn't. And I've been using this camera for about a month or so, primarily as my main cinema cameras for weddings and for production shoots, but I also have been using it to vlog. And a lot of people would say it's not a great vlog camera because the autofocus is not good, but I encourage you, this is not a shameless plug to watch my vlogs, but I have been shooting all my vlogs on the GH5 recently, and I haven't really had too many autofocus problems. So I just wanted to share a little bit about my settings. First off, I'll say right off the bat, if you are trying to see if the autofocus on the GH5 is as good as Canon's dual pixel autofocus or even Sony's on the A6500 or A6300, I will say it is not. It is absolutely not as good as the autofocus systems on those cameras, but it is not an awful autofocusing system. And to be honest, I think a lot of the issues that they actually have currently with the autofocus are actually software or firmware based and not even the actual autofocus system itself. This thing can autofocus very quickly when you actually press the button to autofocus it on what it's looking at. The problem is, it seems like the camera is trying to hunt around every once in a while for what it's really trying to focus on. And so I'm hoping, like I've been hearing, that Panasonic is going to release a firmware update for this that is going to fix that problem with it hunting around. I also want to say right off the bat that all the lenses that I use on my GH5s are all the Olympus M Zuiko or Z-U-I-K, I don't really know how to pronounce it, but all the lenses I have five different lenses and they are all the exact same Olympus M Zuiko lenses, and they have been terrific so far for what I've been using them for. They are all native Micro Four Thirds lenses, so there are no adapters and they are designed to work great with the camera, and they definitely do. So there are a lot of videos on YouTube talking all about the different settings you should change and try this and try that and which autofocus mode should I use and should I use face detection or should I use this or should I use that. Instead of boring you and showing you tests of all the different autofocus settings that they have, and instead of showing you all the different modes that they have, I'm just going to tell you the one that I like the best and the one that I feel works the best for autofocus. So first off, autofocus mode. There are obviously six different autofocus modes on the GH5. It is face detection, tracking, 225 point area, custom multi, one area, and pinpoint. I have found that the face tracking will let you down every single time, and especially if you're used to face tracking on the dual pixel autofocus from Canon or even Sony's, it will let you down, and I can just tell you right off the bat, just don't use face detection. It is not currently working. The box shows up very quickly and actually looks like it knows what your face is, but it just takes a while to get there. I found it to be extremely unreliable, so I bypassed that. The second one being tracking, I personally haven't used that because I've had better experience with the other ones. 225 point area I think is too complicated for actual autofocus when it comes to video, so I disregard that as well. That's probably much better for photos. The custom multi I think is crazy to try to put points all over the place and decide which ones you want to focus on. I bypass that. The one that I use and the one that I think for certain works the best is one area. Plain and simple, with one area, there is a small box, and that box, it obviously tells the camera whatever that box is on to focus on. And I have found this to be by far the most accurate, especially in a vlogging type setup. So all I'm talking about right now are the auto settings. Please don't comment on this video and say that I don't have experience and that autofocus shouldn't matter. I understand all that. I'm just talking about this from a perspective of the people that do want to know the autofocus. When I use one area as my autofocus mode, and I make the one area in the dead center, I found it to focus very quickly and not really have an issue with it. My settings for the actual AF custom settings are the AF speed is +5 and the AF sensitivity is +1. Now I've experimented moving those around and doing different things, and to be honest, I found that they all have different hit or miss results depending on what you're looking for. So I've basically kept it at +5 and +1, and for the most part I think it's worked pretty well. But the setting that has mattered much more is the one area. The one area simply just because it doesn't hunt around, it doesn't look for a face, it doesn't look for certain things. It just says whatever's in the middle of the screen, I will focus on. That's what I'm using right now on this GH5, and I'm actually shooting this at 1.2 aperture, and hopefully it's staying in focus, but it is usually pretty accurate. Now on this camera right now, my main vlog setup, what I usually use is a 7-14 Olympus 2.8 lens. Now I love this lens for vlogging because it's obviously very wide and I can punch in a little bit, but most importantly, it's just wide. And because it's a wide angle lens, it keeps better focus anyway, but I found these settings to be great in no matter what you're actually using. But what I want to show you is some testing, and I'm going to shoot on this camera obviously and then show you the results from it. But basically what I want to show you is the fact that it actually does focus fairly quickly if you have it at one area, because the one area it looks at is dead center and it does a pretty good job. So let me show you some quick testing and I'll let you see from this camera what I'm actually doing as well, so that you can get a better idea as far as that I'm not lying to you. So I usually put the point in the dead center like I have right now, and if I move around the camera, now I'm not seeing the results that I'm getting right now. I'm just quickly moving it around so you can get a feel for whether it's focusing quickly or not. Then I'm gonna point it back at my face. And it looks like it grabbed it pretty quick. And I could turn it around really quickly. I'll zoom into 14 to be a little bit tighter. And you can see that it grabbed my face pretty quickly. I'll move it around. Move it at that camera. Move it back to my face. And as you can see, it's grabbing it pretty quickly. So I really haven't had very bad results at all with this camera doing this, and it's been pretty accurate. It grabs the center and doesn't do a bad job keeping it once it's actually there. So here's another thing that I think a lot of people are not paying attention to that is actually extremely, extremely useful. And that is that there's two buttons on your camera, the shutter button and this back button, the one that changes your autofocus settings. Both of them, when you push in, they instantly grab focus on whatever is currently in the box if you're using one area, or if face detection is on, it will instantly grab focus on the face that it thinks it sees. Now, people are underestimating how good this actually works, because you will actually see in this test how quickly it actually can grab focus, and which is the reason why I think that there's actually an issue with software or firmware and not the camera's autofocus system. Because when you press the button to have it actually focus on what you're looking at, it grabs it extremely fast and has no issue with it. The problem is it hunts for it in other modes, and I think that it's just missing the ball when it comes to that. So what I want to show you is that at 14 millimeter, when I bring this away from my chest and I instantly just reach my hand up to press the shutter button, how quickly it can actually autofocus. I'm putting it against my chest so that it focuses on something entirely different first, and watch for yourself. So shirt, right to face, lock in, and have no problem. The button on the back also does the same thing. And I find that one to be even more efficient. Now obviously I don't use the back one when I am vlogging, because obviously it's kind of hard to press that back one, but I use it constantly when I'm actually shooting video on a job, because what's really nice about this hybrid system is even though the autofocus may not be exactly what you prefer, what's really nice about this system is that you can put it in manual focus and be doing all your manual focus things like you normally would, but then at just a push of a button, you can press this button that's right conveniently located at your thumb and instantly grab focus on whatever's there, and then it remains in manual focus, which is an incredible, incredible feature, because you can still go between manual focus and quickly press that button in to get great autofocus. So all in all, I hope this video is helpful to you. The GH5 is just an incredible camera, and there's a reason I'm doing so many videos recently about it, because it is such a great camera, and because the thing I keep seeing people complain about is the autofocus, I just wanted to show you that there are ways to do it better. and it is very accurate in my opinion when it actually locks in. And if you want to check out some of my vlogs just to get a feel for what it actually looks like in real life, I don't really have a lot of issues with focus. And I think it's just from using the combination of those things, the stuff you get used to. And if they fix the firmware, fantastic. But overall, switch to one area and then mess around with the speed and the sensitivity and decide what's good for you. But I find one area to be very accurate, and I think you will too. So thanks for watching. I would love to hear your feedback. If you found a solution that works even better than this, let me know. Thanks for watching.